Lately, I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars.
Hey, Wildcats and Wildcat parents. This has been way too long. If you're watching this, I'm happy that we are finally almost back for some in-person learning. I know some of you will be going digital, which is fine, and doing some online learning, but I know I'm excited to get back in the building, and we're nervous and anxious and all that other stuff, and just like everybody, and that's okay, but welcome back. I can't wait to see everybody. It's going to be a great year. We'll get going. And thank you, parents, for taking the time to either watch this or to come to Whittier for our soft opening. While you guys go inside with your teachers, your parents are going to watch this, and we're kind of going to go over things like we would at our open house at the beginning of a normal start of a school year. So we do have a few expectations that all of us expect here at Whittier. Treat others the way we want to be treated. Be involved in our school as much as you can. I know it's a little bit different now since no parents are allowed and outside people are allowed in the building. But hopefully this will all start to clear up and we can get things going back to normal and have you in here for family math night. And it might be some kind of program or PTO night or whatever it might be. But no one and nothing that we're going to do here is perfect. We're doing the best that we can. The teachers and I have been adamantly working on a safety plan and trying to do everything we can to make sure everybody stays healthy during this. But we do have to be more flexible and be ready for changes as they may come. There might be a time where, hey, I'm sorry, so-and-so's class is going to be virtual for the next 2 weeks. I hope that doesn't happen, but we have to be prepared for that as we get moved into this. And a lot of that is up to the community health. Really makes the final say on what we have to do and kind of who gets quarantined and who might not get quarantined if that does happen. So we do have to be more flexible, more patient, and I know it might be frustrating, a lot of unknowns still as we kick off the start of this school year. But the bottom line is I do truly believe that Whittier is the best. We have the best families, we have the best students, and we have a pretty amazing staff here as well. So I do truly believe that. One of the big things that I wanted to talk about with all of you was kind of the morning routines and kind of drop-off times. We're used to being able to drop off early, come in the cafeteria, play outside until the bells ring, then we line up and come in. That's not the way it's going to work for right now. We're going to ask that students do not play on the playground before and even after school when they're getting picked up. But all the doors will be locked until 8 a.m. So at 8 a.m., we'll open up the doors, and at your grade level door, you can come inside, or your student can come inside and head straight to their classroom. So the teachers will be in their rooms at 8. We'll open the doors and kind of start ushering people in. We will need to wear our masks as we come in the building. So if a student doesn't have a mask, we will give them one at the door. And so they can do that from 8 to 8:20. And then at 8:20, when the tardy bell rings, the doors will lock. And if you arrive after that time, you're going to have to go around front, check in with Miss Casey to kind of come in the building that way. So it will look a little bit different. The big changes is there's really nobody coming onto school grounds until 8 o'clock. So that's when the doors will open. Kind of if you can, keep your students with you in the car so that we can practice social distancing, make sure they have their masks on. And then when the doors open, they can go in at their designated grade level area. A few of the changes you might see kind of around this school is kind of like water fountain stuff. So we're trying to keep everything sanitary as we can, clean everything. I think going through with the health department and different organizations, you know, we won't be using the drinking part of the drinking fountain. We will use them to fill water bottles. So we do ask, hey, let your student bring a water bottle, but please have them fill it in the morning before they come to school. Put their name on it, and then they'll take it home with them. But no fountains. We'll use the water bottle filling stations. We're going to practice social distancing, talk about it as much as we can, but we will still have to wear our masks throughout the day. We'll try and find times that we can stay 6 feet apart and do that safely so we can take off the masks, whether that's inside or outside. And another big kind of change around the school is we're used to bouncing around level, you know, hey, this group goes here for math, this group goes there for reading, bounce over here. It's a little bit different. We're going to have students remain with their homeroom teacher for a majority of the day. They're going to eat lunch or breakfast and lunch with that group. So that'll be a little bit different for everybody. We did kind of split up even more groups this year to try and use our title resource specialist teachers to try and make our groups as small as we can so we can space out more and hopefully get that social distancing piece down more, masks less, but we still will plan on wearing our mask a majority of the day. This one is really hard for me. It's kind of, you know, sickness and health, and the nurses will kind of be sending out some things, checklists, hey, look at for these things in the morning. It's always been get him here, please, as much as he can. But for right now, this first stretch, at least of 2020, or I guess the last stretch of the year, but the first stretch of the school year, we're asking, you know, to help combat these sicknesses. Keep them home if they're not feeling well. I know that's inconvenient, but it really is paramount to trying to make sure that we can stay in school and keep going with this and really have no major interruptions. The fall will look a little bit different. I don't know about Halloween parades and things like that yet, but as of right now, kind of with the not having other people in the building, there will be no fall pictures. Right now, we will aim for spring pictures, but right now, no fall pictures. This is taking place, the soft opening will take place of our open house. And I know the curriculum office for 4th or 5th and 6th grade and cross country, that they are working on the possibility of some kind of sports things. And even if you are an online learner, if we do sports, you will have the option to participate. We do like to try and push technology as much as we can, and we do like to put out things through technology. So newsletters, they're still going to go out through email. So make sure today at your table, kind of check your email address, make sure they're correct. If you happen to not get email or newsletters and everybody's talking about them or you see them out there, let me know, send me an email. We'll make sure we get you added to the list. If you haven't joined our Facebook groups, please do so. It's an easy way to get information out quickly for us, whether it's like a class change or just important updates or just pictures of our kids doing epic things. It's an easy way for us to do that and connect with you that way. We also, you know, follow the Butte District website. It's www.bsd1.org. If you're not sure, there's also a ton of COVID-related stuff on there as well. There's an app for the Butte School District as well. If you haven't, you can just find Butte School District in the Apple App Store or whatever app store you're using. And kind of like what you're watching now, the YouTube channel, we're still going to have our 6th graders do this. It might look a little bit different, but it is something that's kind of become who we are. You can email to the email on the slide here, buttewildcats@gmail.com. Anytime you're out, maybe you're out camping, out on a vacation. I don't know if there's as much vacationing going on right now as some years, but the classes watch it every day. Kids put on there when they meet their AR goal or important updates from around the school. It's something you can watch wherever you want. You can join the YouTube channel so that you get it sent to you every day as well. If that's something you want, some people just like to watch them at home so they know what's going on around the school as well. But it's kind of a fun way for us to do that. And kind of be involved with as much of that as you can. You know, if you have concerns, for me, airing them out on whatever, Butte 411 or even on our Facebook pages isn't the best way to do it. If you have something that we need to talk about, please email me, call me. I'll get back to you as soon as we can. You know, sometimes it's not as quickly as people want it to be, but there are, you know, we got almost 500 kids, and then each of those have a couple of parents at least, for the majority. So we're talking over 1,000 adults. So sometimes there's a lot going on within the building between meetings and other things going on. But I will get back to you as quickly as I can. And I'd rather try to figure things out that way than airing it out over social media and getting it taken in a million different contexts. But so if you have an issue, please let me know. A couple more things. We do like to compete. I think life is a lot about competing, learning to win, learning to lose, and putting ourselves out there to try and be the best that we can be. So we do a lot of different competitions around the building. And the last thing kind of that I wanted to touch base on with you on was for the online learners. So I know most of you are coming to the soft opening. It's kind of our last group. So you can pick up your supplies, get the work you need. And remember that nothing will start until at least the 8th of September for online learners. And they'll kind of give you the materials, how to do things, where things are going to be posted. But as we get going, remember, you know, we all kind of had questions throughout the night. But the teachers have to go home and be parents and do those things too. So they have to be able to shut school off when they leave the building. So they might not answer you at night. I know a lot of them will because they're just great people. But they need to be able to kind of digress and relax at night and take care of their families and their mental health as well. So it won't be that they're putting you off. It's just once they leave, it's kind of, they need to be able to take care of themselves. Feel something so right, doing the wrong thing. And I feel something so wrong, doing the right thing. I could lie.
I'm Carrie Weichel, the Whittier School Counselor. I would like to welcome you and your children back to school. School may look a little different this year, but like the saying goes, it's what's on the inside that matters most. And on the inside of our school is full of teachers and staff that love and care about your kids. I know I do, and we are going to do everything we can to keep them safe and healthy. There is a lot of added stress on families right now, and you may have noticed your child experiencing some additional sadness or anxious tendencies that you are concerned about. My role as a school counselor is to help support our students' social and emotional needs. My approach may look a little different this year, but it usually involves individual and group counseling, classroom guidance, and the Whittier Character Club, which help promote social skills through character education lessons. We may have to get creative, but I still hope to offer these services in some form this year. I also help with conflict resolution skills and bullying intervention. I am the 504 coordinator for our school and help out with Tier 2 intervention team for students who need some additional supports. This year may present some extra challenges, but we will get through it together as a Whittier family. Please feel free to contact me if you have any concerns about your child and would like to discuss some added supports that they need. We are so happy to be back with our kids. Take care. I look forward to working with you this year.
Thank you all for either watching at home or wherever you might be, or coming to our soft opening. It does mean a lot to us. We're excited to see you guys. Have a good day. We'll see you. Remember, Wednesday starts our official first day for first through sixth. Then kindergarten, you're going to start on Thursday, and you kind of have your soft opening on Wednesday. All right, have a good day.